Okay, so now we're gonna have to do the tires. The tires in for converting the cars are a bit more difficult. First thing we have to do is go to the top panel, click on display, and click on the object filter. Go all the way down and click on just the low days of the wheels and the tires. You can select multiple by hitting the control button and click OK. Now the tires are shown. First thing we want to do is right click on the object and click on the edit button. So basically, we have to memorize the location by hitting the MS button. And since this is the right front tire, we have to load the low detail models of it. So go to the primitives, add object, and scroll down to NFS shift objects. And when a pop-up comes, and then scroll all the way down to the wheels. And this was right front, so we have to load the load B model. And then instead of just clicking update, we have to click on the MR to paste the location. And then hit the update button. As you can see, it moves here. So now just do it again for the load C model. Okay, now we can proceed on to the next tire. Okay, so now we have all the tires configured. Okay, so now head back to the display tab, hit the object filter again, and hit all on. So we can see the whole car again. And now we need to translate everything 20 centimeters down. And you can do that by going to the edit tab, hitting the translate button, going to the z-axis, and typing in negative 0.020. That lowers the car about 20 centimeters down. Okay, so now we're gonna edit the materials of some of the objects. Okay, so now we have to adjust the materials of the tires. So head back to the display tab, hit the object filter. Now just select the load A models of the wheels and the tires. Okay, now we have the load A models in. Okay, now right click on the inside of any of the tires. And hit on Material Pagani C9 Wheel. That will be your car's name right there. Now click on the shader drop down. And scroll all the way down to Bump Map. Bump Cube, sorry. And click on Bump Cube Specular Map T1. And click here. And instead of diffuse 01, we'll have to scroll down to specular 00. And for the bump map, you have to go to normal 00. Okay, so now we have to import some shaders into our directory. We'll have to import all the cube maps. To do this, browse to your Shift Street folder. And browse down to the share.mos file. And if you have the developer tools from rFactor.net, if you don't, I would recommend really getting it. So double click on it with the MOS file viewer utility. And scroll all the way down to anything with the prefix of EMAP. Select anything with the prefix of EMAP and right click. Hit extract. And extract it into your car directory in chassis. The car folder and in chassis, into vehicles and into textures. Hit the OK button and browse back to 3D Simit and click on the cube map. And now browse to EMAP rim. Or just click the E key. It should take you directly there and click on EMAP rim. Hit OK. And for the blend, type in 0.2 and the specular power of 25. This will be for most of the materials. And click on emissive RGB on the box. It'll come up with a pop-up. And go all the way to the bottom. And click on these grays. Click on the most bottom left of these little hexagons. And hit OK. And then go to the blend in the transparent box and hit none. And then click on OK. Now all the materials have been edited to become more shiny, reflective. As you can see, there's our cube map acting. You can see a bit of reflection of the sky. Okay, so now right click on the top of the tire, right there, and click on the tread. And if your car has its own, if it has its own tread, which it should, then keep it like that. And sorry, hit the cancel button, click on the sidewall. Sorry, right click on the tread and open it up. And here should have a diffuse 00, whatever the name of your tire is. And, okay, and go to here and hit specular bump, specular map T1. So bump specular map T1. Click on the specular map. And where it said we had diffuse 00. So scroll down to specular 00. Which is here. So click on the OK button. And then for the bump map, click on normals 00 and click on OK. And go to the blend, select none, specular power to 25, emissive RGB in the setting we put for the last material, which is in the bottom left. And then hit OK. Now, this has been updated a bit more to look more natural. Okay, and sorry, right click back on the tread. Click on emissive RGB and set it to black again. Okay. Okay, and right click back on the tread and set the specular to what we set it last time. Same here, I made a mistake. It should be the specular that's set, not the emissive. So set it back to where it's supposed to be. And hit OK again. Now right click on the sidewall, like right here. Sorry, not that button. Hit material. And here, for my car, it's already like this. Sorry, it's not. Okay, so this should be a diffuse 00. Whereas this should be set to specular bump specular.